This is Matthew Tragesser with the Federation for American Immigration Reform. We're in the Tucson sector today. This sector spans more than 260 miles. It covers the eastern portion of Arizona. It goes all the way into the western border of New Mexico. Now, this sector is a bit different than what we saw in the Rio Grande Valley sector just a couple months ago. That sector covered the southern tip of Texas, and the vast majority of people who were crossing there unlawfully were unaccompanied minors and family units. Here, we're seeing the exact opposite. The vast majority of people, in fact, 17,000 out of 20,000 last month, were single adults. Now, in terms of what we're seeing drug-wise, there have been some strange patterns going on in this sector. Since fiscal year 2018, drugs like cocaine, meth, marijuana, fentanyl have all plummeted in this sector. In fiscal year 2018, more than 135,000 pounds of these drugs were seized. This year, for fiscal year 2021, the sector is on pace for about 20,000 pounds, so more than a 100,000-pound decrease in just about 3 years. In the Rio Grande Valley sector, there hasn't been that much of a decrease. Now, you may be wondering, why is there such a decrease in drug seizures? Why aren't apprehensions here as high as what we're seeing in the Rio Grande Valley? Again, 20,000 in this sector last month compared to 50,000 in the Rio Grande Valley. And a large answer to this is the southern border wall. In this sector, in the Tucson sector especially, much of the border is built with a fortified border barrier with the help of the Trump administration from 2016 to 2020. We did a couple of ride-alongs today. We talked to local ranchers who live along the border, and they've all said that the border wall has been instrumental in not only decreasing illegal immigration, but also stopping drug flows as well. So again, the border barrier is not the panacea or cure-all to what's happening at the southern border, but it has been a very useful tool in really gaining recontrol of the southern border. I also want to talk about the importance of Title 42 in the Tucson sector especially. Title 42 is a public health order that was implemented by the Trump administration at the very beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic. And essentially, this public health order quickly removes unlawful migrants from the country who enter. It is thought to mitigate the spread of COVID-19 and also serve as a border tool to help decrease and deter the illegal immigration numbers that we're seeing. Now, to provide some better context about this tool and how it's impacting the sector, of the 20,000 people who were apprehended here last month in May in the Tucson sector, more than 16,000 were expelled or quickly removed under this public health order back to Mexico or back to the country of origin. So imagine if this public health tool was not put in place right now, those 16,000 or so migrants who entered unlawfully would likely be apprehended and then released into the interior of the country and likely never to be heard again. Now, in recent weeks, the Biden administration has indicated that they will be soon removing Title 42, which comes at the worst possible time. While our country is gaining control over COVID-19, it's not the same case in Central and South America. Illegal alien apprehensions last month for the entire border were the highest in 21 years for any month, 180,000. So combined with the COVID-19 outbreak in Central and South America, but also the high numbers of illegal immigration that we're seeing currently, it's not the best time to be removing this public health order. So we'll be monitoring that. But again, Title 42 has been instrumental in this sector, especially. It has quickly removed those who have entered unlawfully rather than them disappearing into the interior of the country. Again, this is Matthew Tragesser with the Federation for American Immigration Reform. Please click subscribe and also follow us on Facebook and Twitter for more of this content.